बीएससी फर्स्ट सेमिस्टर इन जुआलजी सब्जेक्ट. So last class we have already finished that the phylum Mammalia, the general characteristics of Mammalia, classification of Mammalia, and polymorphism of Mammalia we have already finished. So the subject topic in the first unit, that is the phylum Platyhelminthes. So now what is the meaning of Platyhelminthes? In a Greek word, the platy is nothing but flat. Platy is nothing but flat, and helminthes is nothing but worms. So the meaning of Platyhelminthes is nothing but flat worms. Flat worms, we have to say that Platyhelminthes. So first, in your syllabus, the phylum Platyhelminthes general characteristics of Platyhelminthes. The next one is these are free living and parasitic animals. Means these are free living animals and they are present in parasitic animals. Parasitic means they are present in another body. They have to survive in another body of the animal. They are only get the food by the another, and they will harm to the others. That is a parasitic adaptation, you have to say. Parasitic is nothing but they live in another body. It may be in the stomach or in the liver, any other part of the body they have to live. So that is the main characteristics of the Platyhelminthes. These are free living as well as they are parasitic animals. The next one is these are tissue or organ level of organization. These are tissue or organ level of organization. Means they may be as a tissue grade of organization or organ level of organization. Organs are present or tissues are present in these platyworms. So that is another characteristics of the Platyhelminthes. The next character is they are triploblastic animals. They are triploblastic. Triplo is nothing but three layers are present in these animals. That is a triploblastic animals. So one is ectoderm. Ectoderm is the outermost layer. Then mesoderm, it is the middle layer. Then last one is endoderm. Ecto, endo and mesoderms are the three layers are present in these animals. That's why the name is called as triploblastic. The Platyhelminthes are triploblastic animals. The next character is they possess bilateral symmetry. Bilateral means the body is divided into two equal portions. So that is a bilateral symmetry. The next one, they possess dorsoventrally flattened. Dorsoventrally flattened means the body is flat. If we have to see any animal of the Platyhelminthes, these are flat-like structure. That's why these are called as flat worms. So the body is dorsoventrally flattened. So that's why the name is called as flat worms. The body is dorsomentally flattened. The next character is body is unsegmented. Body is unsegmented. What is the meaning of unsegmented? Unsegmented is these are segment-like structure. But in the flattened elementis, these are not having any segments. In some of the classes, these are the segments are present. Means in body is unsegmented in some of the classes of flattened elementis, but some are having a segments. Segments means suppose we have to take a tapeworm. It is having a segment. So that is a class, that is a cystoid class we have to say. So the body is segmented or unsegmented in one of the classes. The next is body is a coelomate. What is a coelomate? A coelomate is nothing but they are not any body cavity. Body without body cavity we have to say that a coelomate. The body is a coelomate. The body is without any body cavity. There is no body cavity. There is a jelly-like substance is occupied on the layer of ectoderm. There is no body cavity. That is called as a coelomate animals. These are a coelomate animals. The next one is they have the specialized characters for the development or sucking of food. So those are one is hooks. And another one is suckers. And another one is spines. So these are the three main characters which are present in the body of flattened elementis. Hooks, suckers and spines. If we have to see the flattened elementis, one of the animal, these are like this. So here we have to see, these are the hooks. And these are the suckers. So the body is having like this spicules. What is the spines we have to say? Spines. So these are the main special structures which is present on the body of the flattened elementis. That is the main character. Hooks, suckers and spines are present on the body of the flattened elementis. The next character is there is digestive system is incomplete. So digestive is incomplete. It means mouth to anus is absent. Only the mouth is present, but the anus is absent in these the flattened elementis. So that digestive system is incomplete. The next one, the respiratory circulatory systems are wanting. The respiratory and circulatory systems. These are present. These are present. So respiratory and circulatory systems are present, but the digestive system is incomplete. The next one is excretory system is present. Excretory. Excretory is nothing but removing waste from the body. That process is, that system is present in these animals. Next, there is, here I have said the digestive system is incomplete. Means mouth is present, anus is absent. Then how the excretory system is present? So there is a special type of the protoneptilia is present. Protoneptilia is present. By the help of protoneptilia, it will complete the excretory system, but incomplete in digestive system. So that is the main characteristics of the excretory system. The next is nervous system is fertilization is internal. Then last characteristics of general characteristics of plantae element is direct. So that is a development of these are direct. Development is direct or indirect. Means generation may be direct or indirect. Means direct means they produce by direct in the body or they have to enjoin to the other bodies. That is called as direct and indirect. The development of the plantae element is more in the body of other animal. That is the direct. Indirect means it will be harmful to the other animal. That is the indirect character. So the development is direct and indirect. So these are some special general characteristics of plantae element. The main characters are free living, parasitic, and organ or tissue level of organization, and diploblastic, bilaterally symmetrical, and basoventrally flattened. Body is unsegmented and oscillated. Hooks and sucker and spines are special characters or structures present on the body of plantae element. And the digestive system is incomplete and excretory, and the another one is circulatory and respiratory present. And last, the nervous system is primitive, and sense organs are simple, hermaphrodite animals, and fertilization is internal, and development is direct or indirect in these animals. So these are the general characteristics of plantae elements. So next, after general characteristics of plantae elements, that is classification of plantae elements. After general characteristics, in your syllabus, that is classification of plantae elements up to classes with example is there. So first we have to understand which are the classes and some classes of then plantae elements. So that is classification of plantae elements.
Class, we will continue the Turbinaria, Trimotoda, and Cystoda class description.